Hello, and thanks for checking out ChartGuys.com. We're proud to be one of the most successful technical analysis communities online, teaching you the skills to become a more confident, effective, and informed trader. Join our community of hundreds of analysts worldwide working together to learn the charts, generate profit, and achieve financial independence. For access to daily live chart analysis and market coverage, a thriving chat community, along with dozens of hours of exclusive educational materials. We look forward to seeing you. Let's check out some charts. MJ sector check-in. So SPY consolidated today after six gap up opens in a row. And we're seeing a lot of similar consolidation beginning in the MJ space with some correlation. So the Canadian MJ sector clearly more correlated with SPY right now as it's traded on the higher exchanges. And US MJ still doing nothing but really playing defense, trading sideways, doing nothing for the bulls at this point. Patiently waiting for Canadian some guidance as far as what we're going to be looking at for edible regulation. So that's coming in the short term potentially. And we had a lot going on with OH and CL in the USMJ space. We'll look at that at the end. CGC. So we broke the high of yesterday on CGC. It was a gap up open, just like SPY. And then we saw profit taking, just like SPY. Volume, not significant at this point. We know the more likely scenario was we were going to top out before 45.78 and have to pull back and form a daily higher low. So we have our low of key support. And now the bulls have to hold 38.38 and break 44.17 in order to change the daily trend. And CGC has not changed the daily trend ever since we started pulling back from 52.74. We broke resistance, but we never confirmed a higher low and higher high. So that's what the bulls have to pull off heading into next week. And how SPY consolidates will certainly have a significant impact. And we're either going to be looking at a healthy higher low, ideally holding $41. Or if we start to pull back towards 40 or below, it's going to be more of an equilibrium setup as opposed to a continuation setup. Cron today topped out as well, gap up open, very overextended. Some bears made some nice little gains today. Losing hourly uptrends was our indication that our top is set, and we're now looking to see what kind of consolidation we're going to go for. And anything above 1351 is a daily higher low. Bulls have a ton of space to work with, and again, it's just how much pullback are we going to see? Hourly trends changing back to the bulls is what we're going to look for to tell us that our daily higher lows have been established. We did break a key resistance at 1767 on the weekly time frame today for Cron, but if it ends up being a big ugly upper wick on the weekly time frame, it certainly won't be very meaningful. So just like CGC, and we haven't changed the daily trend yet. We're coming off the low and we saw a huge bull move, but we need the trend change confirmation with the higher low and higher high. APHA also started pulling back today. Decent lower wick of bulls buying the dip. You could make the argument this is a cup and handle, and while I prefer my cup and handles to be in uptrends and continuation patterns, the psychology of the pattern is there with resistance, healthy consolidation, the inability to break 768, healthy pullback so far. If this can be a little bit of a daily bull flag and the bulls can make their way back and get over 760 and 768, that will be a bit of a cup and handle pattern, and that would be the first notable shift on the daily trend since we saw the gap down back in mid-April. Have to see a break of those resistances. If we don't break 768, bulls do not prove anything to us on APHA. ACB, also tightening up. We were watching the four-hour equilibrium that was likely setting up, and it's even more likely now. So we've got our low, high, higher low. Lower high was set today, and now we're looking for a higher low compared to 745. It would be bearish if we break 745 because the daily higher low would be broken. I'm looking for the bulls to hold that level at least initially, and we could get a break of this range before the end of the week. If we don't, then we're certainly going to look for it first thing next week. Bulls have to confirm a daily trend change. Otherwise, this bounce is just creating lower highs, keeping those bears in control. TLRY pulling back today, close at the low of the day, gap to fill at 38.98. That's potentially one target, but we have to see the daily higher low and higher high to change momentum. Nice gap up, but clearly we're seeing significant profit taking from that. And we'll be watching for the bulls to change the hourly trend to tell us that our daily higher low has been established. OGI on the daily time frame getting nice and tight. Remember pointing it out in the video yesterday, it was just like ACB on the 4-hour time frame. And we've got our low, high, higher low, lower high, higher low today. Bulls really want to hold 715, otherwise 710 is the must hold, and anything under 755, we're just going to be looking for a lower high. So continued tightening range, but the bulls need to hold tomorrow to stay in this tightening range, just like ACB bulls need to form a higher low compared to 745. So those are two very similar charts to each other. Hexo, we had resistance of 670, and we have earnings, I believe they're tomorrow after hours, double check me on that, but we had a bull break of 670. It's not going to mean anything because we know the earnings reaction is going to dictate whether we can change daily momentum for the bulls or whether we're headed right back down to our lows. A bullish reaction to earnings, and we're looking at 719 key resistance. And 719 is a weekly resistance as well. So bulls ideally want to make their way up to that level if it is a bullish reaction. If it's a bearish reaction, we're looking right back down at the low of 615. So short-term technical analysis isn't really going to mean a whole lot because the earnings reaction will dictate whether we're headed to resistance or headed back to support. TRST, I got the real one this time. I've been doing the banking version of TRST, and that's just because I have to go in and manually select that I want the Canadian ticker. And it doesn't help that the bank, the US bank, looks like the MJ sector right now. But we got the Canadian ticker. Sideways, nothing going on. 7 days within this range, and the range is 682 support to 731 resistance. 8 days now at this point. Patiently waiting for a break. If nothing breaks, who cares? So just trading sideways. Daily 12-period exponential resistance has been rejecting the price. That's now in play. We're either going to see another leg down or the bulls shift momentum and get over those exponential resistances. VFF giving us the most likely scenario as we anticipated, just in terms of staying in this tightening range. Low, high, higher low, and now our lower high is set. We're going to look for a higher low compared to 1180, and we're going to look for a break later next week out of this range, unless there's news. So we'll look to pull back maybe another day or two, then we'll look to bounce and set a lower high, and then later next week, again, watching it on the two-day time frame to condense things down, get it a bit tighter, we can see the tightening range, and we can see we need a higher low. So we got tightening ranges, ACB and OGI, they're likely going to break before the end of the week. Tightening range on the daily for VFF, that's likely going to break mid to late next week. Tightening ranges are great. TGOD support test of 357. And we drop down today to the support is 337. And we drop down to 336. So it's a double bottom at this point, but certainly favoring a bear break. Bulls are not doing anything to help themselves here. Look at the last 3 weeks of trading, or 2 weeks. 10 days, 9 red. Look at the closes. Low, 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 low. Bears just have complete control. There's no buying pressure. Monthly time frame, we're looking for a higher low to form on TGOD. No sign of it. And anything on the daily chart, we have a resistance at 367, but the more important resistance for me is 377. Curaleaf. So this is interesting because Curaleaf broke support and saw no follow through and closed at the high of the day. So any individual name that breaks support wants to see that be the candlestick that happens because it shows us a scenario where we break support and get no follow through. So we look in the other direction, and GWPH is currently doing that on its daily time frame. But if the Curaleaf bulls can do something with this and give us another green day tomorrow, that means pay attention. But 1193 is the resistance. If we cannot break 1193, it's just a daily lower high, but it will be a good sign if we can see another green day off of that support break. CWEB, sideways, nothing going on. 1638 is support. Again, the bulls are playing defense, but doing nothing for offense. 6 days in this little tight range. Support is 1695 and 1638, and bulls have to break 1817 to shift any momentum. IAN closing at the low. So IAN, I said yesterday, time for the bulls to show up if they're going to prove anything, and they did not. So IAN is doing just what other names are doing as far as the week closes. I mean, TGOD and IAN, a little bit more range in TGOD, but as far as the weakness and the candlesticks, one green day in the last 10 trading days, there are certainly correlations with this weakness. We'll see if the bulls can hold 508 support. At this point, 543 is a quadruple top. We can see 1, 2, 3, 4 rejections from 543. That's now the most important short-term resistance, and that's our line in the sand. If the bulls do not break that level, the bears keep absolute control. TRUL, doing nothing. Sideways, 6 days. 1362 is support. 1491 is resistance. So you can get the general theme here, patiently waiting for some kind of trend change or some kind of break, just a break of this range for all these tightening names. MedMen gave us the lower high, which was, again, the most likely scenario. And we're now looking at the potential of an inverse head and shoulders pattern. And if that's going to form, the bulls need to show up tomorrow. If we pull back any further than this, the odds of an inverse head and shoulder pattern will decrease significantly. And the bulls have to hold the all-time low of 251 and break 311 to change this trend for the first time on the daily time frame in a very long time. But again, that's a big red start to the pullback. Bulls need to show up tomorrow, essentially, and form that daily high or low. ZYNE, nice time for news. Bullish news reaction. We were watching the four-hour equilibrium here. Bull break on news, and bulls held very strong. So the weekly time frame, we have our high, low of the pullback, and now we're looking, can the bulls break 1647, or are we going to form a weekly lower high and a weekly equilibrium through June? And tomorrow's going to be very telling. If we see a solid volume green day and a close in the low 14s, that's going to increase the odds that we can break 1647. If we see a bull push and an upper wick and a weak close, then we're going to be looking at the odds of a weekly tightening range being most likely. So OH and CL, generalize what happened today, essentially it is the, I forget which government branch, it is the, someone in the U.S. government needs more information to approve this deal, and that essentially increases the risk that the deal might not go through. So it's no huge red flag, but it's enough for the market to price in a change. Justice Department, probably the Justice Department. So on this news, OH dumped. And OH saw obviously huge bear volume, and the weekly time frame, we're looking down now at support of 857. Noting on the monthly chart, we're still just fine. We're going to form a monthly high or low compared to 503, and we're targeting the 12 period exponential support, which held every test and which Kron has been holding. We're approaching that. Let's see if we flush out. If we flush down tomorrow real quick, I'm going to be looking for an oversold bounce play because the hourly RSI will be oversold. The daily RSI will be oversold. The 4-hour RSI will be approaching oversold and we'll be approaching that monthly support. I would just be looking for an oversold bounce play. And again, I would have to see a flush down of a few percent first thing tomorrow morning before I'd be looking to buy that dip. And the difference between it and CL is CL did manage to close green still, but it's still a very clear downtrend. And we have a little short-term double bottom at 1259, 1255, but bull's not doing a whole lot in terms of convincing that we are shifting any momentum. So bottom line, Canadian MJ, correlated with SPY. Consolidation underway, looking for daily higher lows, and then continuation just like SPY. USMJ trading sideways for 6 or 7 days. Not a whole lot is going on. Bulls are holding support. Bulls are doing nothing to break resistance. We're going to see a clear break in the USMJ sector within a couple days. We can't trade just sideways forever. We're either going to see another leg down or we're going to start to break some resistances. So paying close attention to where that shift is going to be. And we have clearly entered a new market cycle. Markets always go through cycles, whether it's euphoria, fear, whether we have gap up open plays happening all the time, whether we have oversold bounces starting 2 hours before the close. We are currently in a new market cycle where since SPY started ripping higher 6 days ago, things shifted. Canadian MJ correlating with SPY, USMJ staying weak, trading flat. So how are we going to shift in this new market environment and this new market cycle remains to be seen. But we're paying very close attention because we know monthly higher lows are more likely than not on the vast majority of MJ, and a lot of Canadian MJ names are giving us some early signs of monthly higher lows being set. And now the question is, when will the USMJ sector do that as well? I appreciate you watching. Do good things. We'll see you soon.